Did you know that Green Aqua has an AI chat, an artificial intelligence called AI-Scaper that I've been working for almost a year now? It lives in the bottom right corner of the Green Aqua website. So if you go down there, we're building something special here, and you tap on the bottom right corner, you're in the chat. Theoretically, it's supposed to answer most of the questions that our wonderful customer support could answer, but very fast. So in this video, I'll explain how this whole thing works. Welcome to the beautiful world of aquascaping. So what is AI? It's a neural network and machine learning, which works, as I just learned, in a similar way that our mind does, except it does not think, or we don't know if it thinks. But back to the aquascaping and freshwater aquariums and the Green Aqua chat, why is AI useful? Because it can give you an instant real-time information on all aquarium-related issues that you might have. As of today, I'm about 80% ready with it, and I still have to do a lot of programming. So we are shooting this video in October of 2024. By the time that you see this, it's going to evolve a lot. I'm going to introduce new features. I'm going to correct a lot of mistakes. I'm currently working on the translation, so it should be, in a couple of months, it should be working in other languages as well. So by the time that you're checking back, this fruit fly is dead. All I can tell you is that I'm super excited that we have this service, and AI-Scaper is so much more than a general artificial intelligence assistant. And compared with the ChatGPT, I think that Green Aqua has a real edge here, because we built something here that that knows a lot more about our beautiful hobby than a general AI would ever know. In the past 11 months, I had written a very condensed, more than 700 page long knowledge base that I think it's a unique thing, and I don't think that anybody can compete with that at this point. But let's see what the future brings. And how does this whole thing work? Let me present you. How Algae Risk works. Actually, this whole chat was built around this, because we've been talking to customers a lot, and they came to us and told us, okay, I have algae. And maybe they told us the type of algae, maybe not. And then, what should I change? And then we started asking questions. Okay, how big is your aquarium? What kind of filtration you have? What kind of lighting you have? And then we quickly realized that you need to ask a lot of questions, and when you're talking to customers, you will forget occasionally something. And then you might solve one issue, but another one is still there, and they still have algae, and they're unsatisfied. So I started to think, how can I make like a form in Google Forms, for example, and I tried to do it, to ask all the questions that I needed, and I put all the questions together, and I got to a number, 65. So this is not a number from the top of my head. We have 65 questions in that form. And I started, you know, digging deep into the AI, and I found that it's really cool, and I started programming this, and this is how AI-Scaper was born. I just wanted to make a form. I just wanted to make this process that you're right here. So let's do this process together. It takes about 25 to 30 minutes, and you should know almost everything that is to be known about your technology. So volumes, age of the tank, filter type, and everything that you can put your hands on. So let's do the Algae Risk. I will do it very quickly, but my goal is to present you with an Algae Risk evaluation for one of the Green Aqua tanks. We are talking about aquarium number 2, which was built by Luis Cardoso, and you can follow that video on the Green Aqua YouTube channel. We will link that in the description. You type Algae Risk, or you go to the menu, and I have algae issues, and then it will take you to the evaluation. The algae score of 0 represents the ideal situation. So you have a score of 0, it means you have 0% chance of algae. During the session, you'll accumulate penalty points based on potential issues we identify. The higher you score, the greater the risk of algae blooms. The goal is to be below, I would say, 10 to 15%, and all green aqua tanks are between 0 to 5% algae risk, okay? So, what is your aquarium volume? 245 liters. Do you have an open top tank? Yes. How old is the layout in days, weeks, months? Let's see, it's 3 months. Let's continue. Filtration. I have an external filter. Do you use a surface skimmer? Yes, we do use a surface skimmer. What kind of plant fertilizing do you use? I have to check that out. We are using the Green Aqua Rich fertilizers in this one, which is a new fertilizer. It's we're testing it on Luis's tank. I'm sorry, brother. But I have to testify that it works perfectly. So the rich fertilizer will be a combination of the Green Aqua macro and micro, blended together, changed a little bit, so it's going to be a perfect fertilizer. So I would say we're using the rich type. Congratulations, you've just completed the algae risk assessment. If you had any issues, it would explain what those issues are, how to address them. It also helped you during the process, but right here you have these scores classified from the highest ranking or highest score problematic issue to the lowest zero ranking. You have 1% chance of occurrence. Okay, so I missed something here. I was too fast. So consider the low risk still, 1% chance is nothing. Anything below 5 is okay. So I got one for, okay, I got one for the rich type fertilization. The total algae score of 1 suggests excellent overall aquarium health and management with minimal risk of algae growth. This aquarium's performance aligns with Green Aqua's typical 0 to 2% algae scores. Yeah, it does because it's a Green Aqua tank. Okay, so next question. I have also prepared a detailed and extensive algae risk evaluation report for you. How would you prefer to review it? Show and email full report. Show full report or email full report? I would just say show full report right now. So what you have to do, if you have an algae score of 35, for example, you just have to look, what did I get 10 points on? Oh, that, my filtration is not good. Okay, so let's invest into good quality external filter. 10 points are off. So how many more points I have? Oh, I have 4 more points. What are those? Oh, I don't have a CO2 injection. I don't want to invest in that. No problem, you're not going to buy that. That's okay. So you address all the issues from the highest scoring to the lowest scoring, one by one, and you can progress like that. It does best with short, direct questions. Let's see some bad examples. Question, lighting and plants. What is this question? Do I want the relationship between lighting and plants? Do I want lights and plants product recommendations? I'm interested in the topic of lights and plants. So this poor thing will try to give us an answer. And it says, for lighting and plants, we have a variety of options to suit your needs. How much light do I need for a 64 liter tank that has CO2 injection? Now, this is good. It knows the aquarium size. It knows that I'm looking for a light, and it knows that I'm asking about the type of the light. For your 64 liter aquarium, you need a light around 40 lumens per liter, which is 2500 lumens, if you're not using CO2. And if you're using CO2, go for 65 to 75 lumens per liter, which is 4480 lumens. If you type in menu, you get the menu here, which you might click or you might not click. You can continue typing the messages below. Don't click anything if you want to pose a question. I cannot, you know, some people will just contact team and they will ask a question that the AI-Scaper would be able to answer. Now, quite randomly, here are some smart questions that you can ask the AI-Scaper. What are the water parameters of the green aqua tanks? Now you know what are the parameters. And it gave you in like a split second. Do cereal stones change water parameters? We know that they do, but if you don't, so yes, they do significantly. Give me three red plants that do not need CO2 injection. So Ludwigia, Cryptocoryne venti red, Echinodorus reni. It's okay. Even with the best models, you should be aware that AI sometimes hallucinates, especially if the information is taken from the general knowledge base. It does not hallucinate when the information is taken from the green aqua knowledge base. So there are two kinds of knowledge bases that we're using, the green aqua one and the general one. How do you know which one is the general one and which one is the green aqua one? Well, the general knowledge base answers have an asterisk at the end of them. For example, how many products does EIM have? It would not know because they have hundreds of products. So the number of products is not in the green aqua knowledge base. So this poor thing will have to go to the general knowledge base and try to come up with a general answer. The answer is, sorry, I don't know the answer to that question. Can you provide more information to help me understand better? Next, let's talk about some features that I programmed into this chat. The AI is trying to understand what you're saying. These are predefined types of questions that are interpreted correctly by the AI, and it will lead you to pre-programmed algorithms. To give you the right answer. If you phrase them in a different way and the AI-Scaper would not understand that, it would probably not give you the proper answer. What are your opening hours at Green Aqua? Okay, so let's see if it knows. I struggled with this a lot. It didn't know the time. So the current date, actually we're shooting this in September, busted. We're releasing it in October though. And it's 16:59, so we have 1 minute until Green Aqua closes. So right now we're open. What is the status of my order number? And I made a test order for you. Could you please provide the email address associated with the order? So there's a two-factor authentication. Your order, and it gives you the order number from Wednesday the 15th of September, which is an order from a couple of days ago, is ready to be packaged and dispatched as all items are in stock. However, we're currently waiting on a factor that is out of our control, such as the arrival of your bank transfer or the appropriate day to send plants. So we don't send plants on Thursday to Sweden because we don't want the plants to be in transit during the weekend. But if you want to modify anything it, you can say that I want to modify my order number and you give the number again. You will directly modify your order, which is inside the system. How cool is that? And how fast is that? And how convenient is that? Up until a certain point when it's packaged, because when the whole order arrives to our warehouse, we no longer have control over it. The system is in motion. You will get the package, okay? It knows the prices in euro. I'm asking about the price of the EIM 1200 XL, and then it gives you with 20% VAT. If you log into the Green Aqua website, you will see all prices in the corresponding VAT to your country. Do you have EIM 5E600T on stock? So that is the new digital filter from EIM, and I want to know if it's on stock or not. Yes, we currently have enough stock to fulfill an order for an EIM professional filter. I tried this yesterday and it told me, no, we have not enough stock, but it will arrive today. So from yesterday to today, this is real-time information. It just gave you the real-time information. How cool is that? All of these features are using pre-built AI algorithms, and some of them are in the menu. So if you type menu here, then you get all the buttons. So if you click on my order, for example, and then you can get the status, you can track the package, modify order, or contact team. If you go back to the menu again, and you say get advice, then you can ask about algae problems, filter selection, filter specs lookup, light specs lookup, and contact team. Filter selection. This is a really cool little feature. The question is, What filter do you recommend for my 64-liter tank? For the system to know what filter to recommend, the first question, what is the volume of the tank? So you have to specify. And then it starts a huge process, which, check this out, for 64-liter aquarium, select a filter with a minimum flow rate of 640 liters per hour, ensuring a turnover rate of 10x. It gives you some recommendations, and then we arrive to the choices. Now, let's go to the menu. I want to send a ticket. So if you press menu, you will get contact team right here. I will click on contact team, ticket submission. Welcome to the Green Aqua Support Center. So you're no longer in the AI chat part, you're in the support center, send a message to the team part, okay? Very important, you're not in the same place anymore. It tells you. So again, some people just don't read what's written in front of them and they try to ask a question here. How high is an ADA 60P aquarium? I'm trying to ask a question when he's trying to ask my name, okay? Please provide an email address. Email address, I will give info@greenaqua.hu. How can I assist you with your Green Aqua? This is a test question. Thank you for submitting your inquiry. How high is an ADA 60P aquarium? Your ticket number is 62131. We get to the last question. Who makes better tanks, Tommy or Balaj? That's the question of the day, okay? So let's ask it. What does it say? Whoops! What happened? Thank you for your understanding. We appreciate the passion and enthusiasm shown in the discussion about tank making skills. At Green Aqua, we strive to maintain a positive and respectful environment for all our customers, ensuring everyone feels welcome and valued. Thank you for the conversation, and we hope you will continue to support Green Aqua. Peace. It kicked me out, okay? So this led me to the offensive intent. So let's keep this conversation peaceful and right on the topic. Obviously, you can restart the chat and start again anyway, but this whole project is a really fun and a great project, and I really hope that it's helpful for you. So it hopefully will complement the stellar performance of our customer support and give you instantaneous and useful answers. And the question should be all related to freshwater aquariums and Green Aqua. So other topics are not really covered in our knowledge base, and AI-Scaper was actually instructed not to answer those questions. We want to keep this inside the aquascaping ecosystem. Let me know what you think about this chat and what am I missing. Feel free to use it and enjoy. We'll see you next time. Goodbye. Next one. Oops. Now this is a mosquito, so I don't want that guy in my house. It's up there.